Hey, hey y'all. This is Yaya. Very, very excited to be here with you today. I'm going to go ahead and write the title in the comments. Hey, Lady Baltimore, how are you? I will actually be in Baltimore this weekend. Let's see. 10 relationship rules for business women. I hope y'all are ready because I am ready. Hello, Miss Shelberry. Good to see you. Rules for, and if you can, go ahead and share it out to your friends, to your followers, because I know that you know someone who needs to get their relationship life in order. Let's see, and here's me. All right, let's pin that right there. So good to see y'all. So good to see y'all. So I'm going to give you guys some time to pop on. I know that, are you here in Atlanta? No, I'm not. I'm in New Orleans. So I'm close enough. I feel like Atlanta is like New Orleans number two. Well, New Orleans number three after Houston. Hello, hello, everyone. So good to see you guys. So good to be here with you. So for those who do not know who I am, I am Yaya Smith of The Inspired Life. I am a wife, a mom, an entrepreneur, a mom of three actually, and another one is on the way, y'all. So when I talk about relationships, when I talk about legacy building and family building, when I talk about relationships, legacy building, family building, it's definitely my come from. So this is what I live every day. I'm able to homeschool my children and just enjoy a really amazing, amazing business that is informed by my life. And so again, I'm Yaya Smith, and my passion is supporting women to create businesses that are informed by their lives, but also to create relationships, marriages, families, and legacies that work well and play well with that business, with your vision, with your purpose, because it's not always a business. Sometimes it is just the vision that you have for your life or the purpose that you're ready to live out. And many times we feel like a relationship would hinder that, or we feel like having a family would stop that in some kind of way, or that's what we're told, that's the narrative that we pick up. But guess what? There are women out here doing it every day, and you can make it look like whatever you want it to look like. But it's important for you as a woman to know where you're going, to have that vision, to have that clarity around what it is that you're creating. So hello, hello, so good to see you guys. So good to see you guys. Thank you for the hearts. So the reason that I chose this topic for today is because I think that a lot of us millennial, entrepreneurial, you know, women who are busy on the go, we think that there is this separation when it comes to the men in our life or the relationships in our life and how we get our money, how we make our money, how we exercise and express our purposes. But really there isn't. And one thing that I found with working with so many women, I've had the privilege, y'all, to work with hundreds of women this past year alone. And I think with the new baby coming, I'm like trying to scale back a little bit this year, but 2017 was really, really good to me. And I got to work with so many women. And I think that what I saw the most was that a lot of women feel like those things can't live together in their life. Like, especially, you know, young, single, on the move, you kind of feel like, I can't be distracted right now. I can't deal with a relationship right now. I can't deal with a marriage right now. I can't deal with kids right now. I can't deal with any of that because I'm focused on getting this money, getting myself stable, doing what I have to do. I'm hustling, I'm grinding. And the truth of the matter is you can design a life where hustle is not your lifestyle, grind is not your lifestyle. And yes, those things are beautiful in a season. There is a season for those things. But making it a lifestyle is a habit sometimes we fall into. And then you get to that 40, 50 age range and you're looking back like, man, I missed out on a whole lot of life. I missed out on a whole lot of time. I missed out on the things that really mattered to me that I thought I was doing it for. So I am on a mission to support women not to have that kind of regret, not to have that kind of, I wish I had, I wish I would have, and to really see that you can have it all. You absolutely can have it all. Now, can you have it all the time, all at once? No. So right now, my babies are taking a nap, and my husband is working his business, editing pictures. But with help, with support, and knowing the rules around how to build a relationship that works with your business, how to build a relationship that works with your purpose, and those things that many times we get into situations, as you know, we hear all the time, where we're unequally yoked. You want to make sure your visions are equally yoked as well. You want to make sure your purposes are equally yoked as well, and that makes for very easy legacy building together. So today, again, we are talking about 10 relationship rules for business women, and I'm going to hop right into it so that we have a little bit of time at the end for question and answer. So like I said, the way that you handle men in your life and the way that you handle money is often very similar. Those two things work on almost like the same plane, or they run parallel. So many women say, you know what, I've been hurt too many times in a relationship, so I'm gonna focus on my money. And that same focus that they were giving to the men in their lives, maybe their daddy issues, maybe mommy issues, all those things, we just shift that focus. So you're giving it that same energy, and you're expecting that same thing back. You're expecting that provision. You're expecting that security. You're expecting that protection. So the first rule is to unplug from the struggle. Unplug from the struggle. That goes for your financial life as well as your relationship life. It's important for you to be clear on what it is that you want to create so that you're not speaking struggle over your relationships. So you're not going into it thinking, he about to be a distraction and I don't know if I got time for that. So you're not going on that first date or hopping, getting on a call or swiping left like, look, I really don't have time for these dudes. I'm just on here trying to kill some time right now. You want to go into it with a mindset of abundance. You want to go into it with a mindset of, I am interviewing for my legacy right now. And when you know that you're valuable, when you know that you're worthy, when you know what you bring to the table, you realize that whoever I allow into my life, whoever I choose, whoever I invite into my space, had better be coming with legacy on his mind. And it's not about struggling together and all those different things, because then the struggle becomes, you know what, we're building a success story here. We're building legacy here. We're building a future here. And so unplug from the struggle. Make sure that your language, make sure that the stories that you are hearing, make sure that the stories that you are telling, make sure that your news feed is not feeding into that struggle of men and women can't get along, successful women can't be married, successful women are the least likely to be married, which is an absolute lie. And there are real numbers behind that. Successful women are married very often, actually. The way that CNN would have you believe, successful women are married, 10% of successful women are married, when that's absolutely not the truth. So, as a successful woman, and that's where you are, whether you feel it or not right now, whether you believe it or not right now, you are successful. You should be successful in every area of your life, including your relationships, including your family life, including your personal life. So when the lights go down, when you leave the office, when you get off the phone with clients and everything is settled, your day is done. That success is a feeling that you feel from the inside out. Oh, you are so welcome. So make sure that your environment feeds into what you are actually envisioning for yourself and not into that struggle. So unplug from the struggle. That is the first rule. The second rule, and this is a hard one, so grab your edges, ladies. Grab your edges. In case you don't know my style, you might want to grab your edges, okay? Acknowledge your truth without attaching to it. Acknowledge your truth without attaching to it. And the reason I say that is because as women, we tend to acknowledge and attach ourselves to the collective truth. So we say, as women, we're out here, we're all out here being abused. As women, we're all out here in the fight. As women, we all out here. And at the end of the day, your life is what you make it. And while it's okay to acknowledge that many of our sisters and women that we know are in these struggles, and some of us have experienced those same struggles, it's important for us not to attach our story of who we are, what we can have, to what we call our truth. Because at any moment, and I hope this encourages somebody, at any moment you can change your truth. So if your truth so far has been, I'm attracting all these deadbeats, I'm attracting these dudes that aren't trying to commit, aren't trying to do nothing with their life, what is going on? That doesn't have to be your truth from this moment forward. So you have to acknowledge your truth, because you know you want to keep them lessons, keep what you learn from it, but you don't want to attach to it going forward. Because sometimes your truth can become baggage. Your truth can hold you back. Your truth can keep you stuck in the pain, in the history, in the heartbreak of toxic relationships that came before, and blind you to the beauty that's available to you in your life. And I don't only mean toxic relationships with men. Sometimes it was a toxic friendship. Sometimes it was a toxic mom. Sometimes it was a toxic sister or brother who has influenced you to have difficulty trusting people. So I want you to acknowledge your truth without attaching to it. The third rule is observe the patterns. Observe the patterns in your life. Observe the patterns, and this goes for your business, this goes for your relationships, this goes for everything that you put your hands on. Observe what you are attracting on repeat. Okay? Because the truth of the matter is, think about this. If you play a song on repeat, you really like it, don't you? If you watch a movie over and over again, it's because you really like it. So if you are attracting the same kinds of people, the same kinds of situations, the same money situation, the same man situation, then it could be that something in you may be addicted to it. May really like it, but consciously you like, I don't like drama. I don't like arguing. I want commitment. Subconsciously, there may be something in there that is pulling that pattern into your life over and over. But if you don't even notice the pattern, then you won't know how to end that pattern. Or if there is a positive pattern, how to keep that pattern going. So many of us, if you own a business, many of us have experienced success in our business, but we were moving so fast, we didn't know how we made that happen. And success is a formula. Life is math. I say that all the time. Life is math. And people will tell you, unsuccessful people normally, oh, well, you know, there's no formula to it. It's just luck. You're just moving about your life and things just happen. And no. Life is math, boo. And if you plug in 1 + 1, it's gonna be 2 every time. So notice the patterns in your life, and those patterns that you wanna keep, start noticing what you're doing to make those things happen. And those patterns that you wanna get rid of, start noticing also what you may be doing, what you may be saying, what you may be thinking, as calling those things into your life. And so the fourth rule is to check yourself. Check yourself. Very often, just like with your money, with those men, you are your own bottleneck. Picture this. If you are that woman who is listening to, and I, no shade to K. Michelle, no shade to Keisha Cole, no shade to Mary J., but if that's what you are listening to on repeat, and you singing it, and oh girl, this my song, and all of your emotion and all of your feeling is going into it, guess what? You will keep creating that and not even realize it. If you are being entertained by toxic relationships, toxic friendships, you like watching women throwing drinks at each other and all these other different things, then subconsciously you will call those things into your life because you are giving your energy to that. So really, really check yourself. Check what you're entertained by. Check the type of music that you like. Check the conversations that you have. If one of your friends is perpetually single, and every time she come around, y'all, ooh, yeah, girl, because you know how these men are. Guess what? You're going to attract that same kind of situation that she's attracting. So make sure that you are not the bottleneck in your relationships. Make sure that you are also not the bottleneck in your business, girl, because we are flourishing in 2018, okay? So self-analysis is the key to growth, y'all. Self-analysis is the key to growth. I'm so glad you're getting your life right now, girl. Self-analysis is the key to growth in every area of your life. And guess what? Self-sabotage is real. Self-sabotage is real. So because I'm with my business women here, because I'm with my business sisters, I know a whole lot of y'all have read the War of Art. And the War of Art talks all about resistance. And that bottleneck, that's your resistance in your relationships. You don't only experience resistance in your creative expression. Sometimes you experience resistance in your relationships. Because I used to be that one, like, oh my goodness, things are going too good. Something must be about to happen. He can't be this good. He can't be this nice. He can't, because men aren't like that. Mm-mm. And I would sabotage the relationship before they could. And I would break up with them before they could break up with me. Because I was my own bottleneck and I was sabotaging myself. So if that is you, check yourself, girl. So the fifth rule, y'all might want to write this one down. Pack light, but don't leave empty. Pack light, but don't leave empty. So we talk about baggage, we talk about cleansing, we talk about doing all the, you know, I'm doing my inner work and I'm healing and I'm taking care of my self-care. You want to make sure that you're packing light, but you're not leaving empty. Because each and every one of those bags that you've picked up in your life, whether it's your truth, whether it is your pain, whether it's your history, whether it's your successes, each and every one of those bags had something valuable in it. And you don't want to throw out your Chanel bag with that Massimo from Target. You want to make sure that you're packing light, but you're not leaving empty. You want to make sure that you are not taking all of the baggage with you, not taking the residue, not taking the scum, not taking the dirt, but that you are taking those valuables with you. And sometimes we can't see what those valuables are. Sometimes we go through life and we're looking at the bag so much that we don't see what's inside of the bag. So, the sixth rule is to require an investment. So for those of you who were on the last time that I was live for Business Rules for Women, you know, require an investment. You are way too valuable to be giving yourself away for free. Do not do anything for free. If this man is not willing to give you commitment, understand that there is nothing that he deserves from you either. You do not have to prove your worth. You do not have to prove that, you know, he should commit to you because you're so worthy. No. Your presence is what makes you worthy. Your softness is what makes you worthy. Your femininity, your vulnerability, all of those things that you bring to the table is what makes you worthy. And if he doesn't see that and isn't willing to invest, then you should not invest your time either. Because your time is something you can't get back. I coach with so many women and I love, love, love what I do. One of the things that I hear most often isn't, oh, I spent so much money on him. Oh, you know, I wish that I had. No, it's I wasted so much time. At the end of the day, we all realize that our time is our greatest investment. So do not commit your time, do not invest your time in a situation that is not willing to return that investment. So require an investment. Know your value and don't give it away for free. Have boundaries. Have boundaries. One thing that I tell women all the time is that if a man hasn't committed to you, all that time on the phone all night, we don't have time for that. He shouldn't even know how much time you have available. Hey, how you doing? Oh, okay, cool. You want to get together? If he's not your look, if he's not trying to schedule a date days in advance, not, hey, oh, I was thinking about you. You want to get together tomorrow? I'm busy. Because that lets him know I have access to her time like that. I'm giving you the game. Little bit of tidbits. Make sure you're picking it up. Require that investment, okay? Hey, Jessica, so good to see you on here. Yes, I can. So, we're on rule number 6 now, so I'll go through them one more time just for the people who are coming on late. The first rule was to unplug from the struggle. Your relationships do not have to be a struggle, and you don't have to carry that story. The second rule is to acknowledge your truth, but don't attach to it. It's okay to acknowledge your truth, but not attach yourself to it. The third is to observe your patterns. Observe the patterns. What are you attracting? Is it good? Is it bad? Do you want to keep it? Do you want to let it go? And observe the things that you may be doing, saying, thinking that are creating those patterns in your life. The fourth is to check yourself and make sure that you are not the bottleneck in your relationships. Make sure that you are not the one that is sabotaging yourself and sabotaging those relationships, maybe because of a truth that you've been attached to, maybe because of something that you've been holding on to this whole time. The fifth rule, y'all, is to pack light but don't leave empty. Pack light but don't leave empty. And I know somebody is gonna go post that as a meme or as a quote on their page, so make sure you give me my credit, girl. So pack light, but don't leave empty. And that means, yes, you have baggage. We all have baggage. But as you are going through your process of cleansing and all of those things, make sure that you're not throwing out the bag with the bathwater. Make sure you're not throwing out the Chanel with the Massimo, okay? And then the sixth rule is to require an investment. Know your value, know your worth, and don't just give yourself away for free, don't give your time away for free, and don't give your love away for free. The seventh rule, ladies, invest in your education. Invest in your education. And what I'm not talking about going back to school and getting another degree. You got enough degrees. I'm talking about the education that school didn't give you, the education college didn't give you, and that education that you feel I'm just gonna have to stumble my way through life, keep playing Russian roulette with my heart in order to learn this thing. One second, I'll go back to number 5 to just give you a quick explanation. Invest in your education, ladies, just like everything else. You're not going to get on the road without training. You are not going to go and operate on someone's heart without training. So why are you handling your heart? Why are you handling your cleansing, your processing, your healing without any kind of education? You just said, I'm a shoot in the dark and hope it hits. Invest in a coach if you need to. Invest in a class. Invest in learning from someone who is succeeding in it. Okay, because there's plenty of non-relationship having relationship coaches and unmarried marriage coaches. Invest in someone who is succeeding and has a track record of helping other people succeed. And not that person who's just speaking to your pain, but the person who is speaking to your solution. Everyone does need a coach and a mentor. I'm going to see my coach this weekend in Baltimore. Everyone needs a coach. I am definitely an advocate for coaching and mentorship. It's amazing. In every area of your life, if you are not succeeding the way that you want to, invest in that area. You're investing in your business, invest in yourself, invest in your heart, invest in processing your past so that you can get past it and get into your future. So really quick, packing light but not leaving empty, packing light but not leaving empty. So I'll give a personal story. I was in a relationship a few years back, and my website is my handle without T-H-E in front. So inspiredlife.com. And you can go to my page and click the link in my bio, and there's all of my links there. So I was in a relationship maybe 10 years ago. So I've been married for some time now. I would love to coach you. I absolutely would. I've been married for some time now, but that previous relationship was so toxic, y'all. There was so much abuse, from physical abuse to mental abuse to verbal abuse. And at the end of the day, I'm not blaming only him, because I took part in it too. And what I learned from that relationship is a lot of what I teach now. That, yeah, I'm gonna get rid of the relationship. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of him. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of all of the pain that came with that, so that I'm not carrying that into, trust me, I'm okay. I'm not carrying that into my marriage, so that I can hold space and have space for a man who's going to treat me well. But I also learned that what I put out was exactly what I got back. That was the value inside of that bag. And I taught him how to treat me. So I wasn't taking care of myself. I wasn't holding myself to a higher standard. I wasn't committing to myself. I was making goals, but not committed to them at all. I was that person that was distracted and procrastinating. And I said, well, why isn't this man committing to me? I'm giving him my all. But I wasn't giving me my all. So why would he give me his all if he saw from how I was treating me that I was only worth half or maybe a quarter? But I felt that he was worth more. And so that was the value inside of that bag, that whatever relationship I go into next, I'm going to make sure that I have my all, so that I have my all to give, so that I'm serving from my overflow instead of serving from my supply. You want to serve from your surplus and not your supply. So now in my marriage, my husband knows how to treat me because he sees how I treat me. And so that's what I mean by, you can throw the baggage away without throwing the value away. Yes, I will save this life. So investing in yourself was rule number 7. Rule number 8, y'all, rule number 8, trust your gut, but don't fall into fear. And that's a question I get very often. How do you know the difference between your intuition and fear? And the truth is, your intuition is not saying what if. Your intuition does not say what if. Your intuition knows. So your gut knows. So when you meet that person and you're like, mm-mm, that's not my client. Mm-mm, that's not my husband. That's not him. But, and I'm kind of preaching to myself now, because I didn't say yes to a couple clients this year, and I was like, I know I'm not supposed to be working with you. But a lot of times we think we can help everybody. A lot of times we think we can fix everybody. And so we go against our gut. Sometimes we reach that 37, 38, 39, 40-year-old age range, and we say, man, what if this is like the last person? Or I'm really tired of having to start over again. I really don't want, so I'm gonna just try to make it work with this person. When your gut is telling you, this ain't him, and he could be right around the corner, but your fear is saying, well, what if nobody? I mean, look at what the dating pool is like out there. You don't want to be on Tinder, do you? You don't want to be out here on OkCupid, do you? And look at all your single girlfriends out here. They can't even get a date. So you don't want to be like them. So you might as well hold on to this okay thing that you have. You want to trust your gut without falling into fear. So when your gut say no, is no from the beginning. Because that thing that you really want, may be right behind your yes. It may be right behind you saying, I'm gonna say yes to that next step, to that unknown. So trust your gut, but don't fall into fear. Rule number nine, and this is for my sisters out here who, you got 3 degrees, you got your PhD, your JD, you are doing the dang thing, honey. Okay, you are traveling, you got it together, but this relationship thing, you just can't seem to get a handle on it. Look, you are a 5-course meal, okay? Serve yourself accordingly. You are a 5-course meal. Serve yourself accordingly. When you go out and have a 5-course meal, they're not putting all the doggone plates on the table at once. And we tend to do that because we're trying to prove our worth. We want to show all of our cards. We want to show him everything we have to offer. My husband didn't know I could cook until he came 2 hours out of town to visit me. You gonna show up and show out to get some of this good cooking. I'm sorry, sir. So understand that whoever you are, whatever level you're on, you are an amazing woman. You are a 5-course meal. Serve yourself accordingly. You don't have to give all of you. I tell my husband all the time, we've known each other for 10 years, and there are parts of me you do not know yet, because there are parts of me I don't know yet. And that keeps it fresh. That keeps him in that space of, I love her, man. I want to get to know her, man. There's always so much variety. She's so full of surprises. Like, that keeps him in that space of constantly chasing, constantly uncovering, constantly digging for the treasure inside of you. So understand that you are a 5-course meal. Just serve yourself accordingly. Don't give all of yourself at once. Don't feel like I have to put all of my cards on the table to prove to him that I'm better than the next woman, because there's so few good men out here. Mm-mm. There are more than enough good men for each and every one of us. Act like it. Act like there are, like people say all the time, there are plenty customers for you. There are plenty clients for you. There's no such thing as competition. You continue working on you, and there will always be more than enough of yourself to give. So you don't have to try to give all of you at once to prove that you are worthy of that relationship. And then rule number 10, ladies, find the value in your vulnerability. Find the value in your vulnerability. And this is one of the reasons why I say men and money are on the same wavelength. Men and money are on the same wavelength. Many of us, even women in business, we say things like, oh, well, I'm not really doing it for the money. I just want to help people. You know, it's really not about the money. What are you in business for? Start a charity, girl. And then we want a relationship, we want a husband, but we look at our vision board and we say, you know what? I want a husband, but if he don't come, it's all right. You have to find value in being able to embrace and acknowledge and say, yes, I want a husband. Yes, I want a man. And there is no plan B. And I don't want any old husband. I want my good thing. I want the man God has for me. I want the one that's being prepared specifically for me to fit every one of my nooks and crannies and all of my idiosyncrasies. I want him. Yes, I want him. I want my ideal client. I want that person that is meant for me and my business, that's going to get the best results, that's going to give me glowing reviews. Yes, I want that. And you have to be very vulnerable to say those things. You have to be vulnerable to when your ego and your mind is like, look, girl, it ain't coming, so you might as well settle for what you got. You might as well stop even mentioning it, because it's just going to cause you pain if you keep talking about it. It's just going to hurt. You're just going to keep crying yourself to sleep at night. You might as well just say, I'm good without it. That vulnerability is what says, you know what? No. Because I've been convincing myself for too long that I'm okay without it, and I'm really not. And you're not going to attract anything that you don't really want, that you won't let yourself want. So if you've taken any of my classes, one of the first things that I teach is to allow yourself to want what you want. Embrace your desires. The scripture tells you God will give you the desires of your heart. But guess what? If you won't even admit that you desire it, he ain't about to waste no time giving it to you. Because when you get it, you may sabotage it. When you get it, you may, it might not be that good. Don't worry about it. I'm good. Because you can't have those same conversations. You got to level up. You got to show up in a different way as a wife. You got to show up as a different way, in a different way as a million-dollar businesswoman than you do as somebody that's just out here hustling for $1,000. So, and find the value in your vulnerability allows you to be open to receive what it is that you are actually asking for in your relationships as well as in your business. So really, really quick, let me go through the 10 rules again. The first one is to unplug from the struggle. Rule number 2, acknowledge your truth without attaching to it. Rule number 3 is observe your patterns. Observe your patterns and what you are attracting into your life. Rule number 4 is to check yourself. Make sure that you're not the bottleneck in your relationships. Rule number 5 is to pack light but don't leave empty. Rule number 6 is to require an investment. Require an investment. Rule number 7 is to invest in your education. Invest in becoming the best woman, the best mother, the best wife that you can be, because there's more to you than just your business. There's more to you than just helping others and serving others and being that face for the crowd. There's more to you than your brand. There is more to you than that, and you can express all of those sides equally. Rule number 8 is to trust your gut. Trust your gut, but don't fall into fear. Rule number 9 is that you are a 5-course meal. Serve yourself accordingly. Don't put all your cards on the table. Don't put all your plates on the table. Make sure that you are serving accordingly. And rule number 10 is to find value in your vulnerability. Find value in your vulnerability. So, with that, for those of you who are like, yes, I want to work with you, I want more, yes, definitely subscribe for those replay emails and follow Business Rules for Women so that you're getting all of these replays. But for those of you who definitely want more, who are like, look, I need to know the details, I need to know how to get this together, I have an offer for you. For one of my classes that literally this class is not available anywhere else. You can only get it through Business Rules for Women. The class is the Men and Money Masterclass, and it was my best-selling class of 2017. Best-selling class of 2017, y'all. So, this class normally is $497. If you click the link in the Business Rules for Women bio, you will see it for $497. But today, I want to make sure that anyone who wants access to this class can get it, because I know that this information can change your life, like seriously, your man life and your money life. So, the class is the Men and Money Masterclass. The Men and Money Masterclass, and if you use the coupon code BRFW, BRFW as in Business Rules for Women, all caps, you can get $300 off of this class. Yeah, $300 off. So don't sleep on it. Make sure that if you want this, you cannot find it anywhere else other than grabbing it from Business Rules for Women's link in the bio. Use the code BRFW for $300 off of the Men and Money Masterclass. Men and Money Masterclass. It is awesome. It's a 6-week class video, so you get to see more of me. Video, you get workbooks for each one of the weeks, and they're not, you know, these super extensive 20-page workbooks, but the questions will have you dig so deep that when you come out on the other side, you will be a new woman, a better woman, and you will have a completely different perspective on your man story and your money story and how to heal both of those things so that you're getting what you want in your relationships and you're getting what you want from your business so that you're open and ready to receive. So with that, again, you want to tap the link in Business Rules for Women bio and use code BRFW to get $300 off of that class. Like I said, you can go to my website definitely if you want to coach with me, but if you want that class specifically, look, you only getting it from Business Rules for Women. So take advantage of that while it is available. Invest in yourself. It's a $197 investment. You are well worth it, far beyond worth it. So for those of you who are still here and have questions, let's do a really, really quick, let me see where we are. Really, really quick, any questions, any comments, any aha moments, let me know. It was a good class. I'm so glad you enjoyed it. Hey, I am Rain Online. Okay, we have a little bit of time for question and answer. I'm so glad you guys loved it. So were there any aha moments? Were there any like, oh my goodness, girl, let me go grab my castor oil and my silk scarf for these edges? Let me know. Truly enjoyed this class. Thank you. Thank you very much, Makeup by Jess. Thank you. You can definitely tap on my name, The Inspired Life. I go live all the time. I am always live streaming. So there's plenty more. Where this came from, what made you decide to change your life around? This is a really, really good question, and I get it all the time. 5-course meal, so good, so good. No, you didn't miss it. You can watch it. You can watch the replay. Okay, I'll come back to that question, but what made you change your life around? I get this question all the time, and I only coach women who have reached this point. No matter how successful you are or unsuccessful you are, at some point you get to a space where you are so ready to evolve. So if you think about in offline, my husband and I, we are urban farmers. So we grow food and we have city lots, where we have gardens and things like that. If you think about a seed, when you plant that seed, there comes a point where it has to break open and grow. And I got so tired of being stuck inside of the struggle, inside of my story, inside of the bags that I was carrying around. I got so tired that I had to change. And so I love seeing women get to that point where they're like, look, something gotta give. And I have seen women who are multimillionaires reach that point, because every one of us was designed to continue to grow and flourish and thrive. And sometimes we rest in our success. Sometimes we rest in our business. But there will come something to shake you up in your life and make you want more. And that's the point that I got to. The point where I was ready to see something else, something new, something more positive. I was tired of pain. I was tired of hurting. I was tired of trending on the negative side and always being that one like, girl, you know she calling, she got a problem. What's wrong? What's the issue? And that's where I really was. And getting to motherhood, I realized I didn't want to pass that on to my children. And I didn't want to bring that into my marriage. So I knew I had to change me. And my dad told me something one time. I have the same daddy story as a lot of people. Didn't grow up with him in the house, but I got into a relationship with him later on in life. And he said, if everybody is saying the same thing about you, you're the common denominator. If your relationship with everybody looks the same, you're the common denominator, and it's time to change you. And that really, really stuck with me. So that was like a push in the direction of changing, really changing. Let's see. What do you do to encourage yourself when or if you feel down? I listen to good music. I get out of the house, because usually if I feel down, it's because I'm not being as productive as I should be. Or I'm not pouring into myself like I need to. So I may schedule a spa day, or I may just schedule some time away from the house, away from the kids. I may get a babysitter and go out with my husband. Reading really helps when I'm feeling down. Reading something positive and uplifting. talking to my coach because she'll snatch my edges right quick. But yeah, those are the things that I do. And even like I said, just listening to music, taking a nice soak in the tub, pouring into myself helps me to feel better when I'm feeling down. Let's see, how do you feel about women approaching men? I don't feel that women ever have to approach men, really. Men are always in pursuit mode. And if you take the Men and Money Masterclass, we talk about stepping out of that space of pursuit. Because when we're in that I have to hustle, I have to grind space, as women, we are in pursuit of money. And you can change that dynamic to where money is pursuing you. You can change that dynamic to where men are pursuing you. And it's a much more comfortable place to be. I'll say that. It's much more comfortable for men and money to be coming after you than for you to be going after it. So while I won't say that a woman is wrong, I will say that many times you are putting yourself in an uncomfortable space. And because I'm a femininity coach, I coach on femininity, like being a feminine woman. And that doesn't mean pink and pearls all the time. That means embracing your essence and embracing your original design. We are designed to set the tone, where men are designed to set the pace. So if we try to set the pace in relationships, we'll notice that men pull away a lot more often. Men don't commit a lot more often because we're trying to set the pace. Being in pursuit is setting the pace. I personally don't even respect a man who expects a woman to pursue him, because that means further down the line, you're gonna be saying, well, why won't he take the lead? Well, because you set the tone of you taking the lead from the beginning, and he was okay with that. That's kinda like, bruh, your mama might still be washing your clothes, bruh. And I don't really want that man. I don't really want that man. Let's see. You got to be tired of being tired. Absolutely. Absolutely. What was the first step you took once you knew you were ready? I really went about a year just self-analyzing and getting back into God, getting back into scripture, getting back into my spiritual walk, looking at myself and looking at those patterns, like I told you guys, and saying, what have I been attracting and why? And a lot of it went all the way back to childhood. A lot of it went all the way back to kindergarten, and things that happened in the classroom, and things that happened on the play yard, and things that happened in my home that I had buried so deep inside of me. So that was my first step, to really take the time to analyze me. And I'm a very analytical person. Take the time to analyze me and be very honest with myself and be very real with myself. That was step one. How do I go about you being my coach? So you can go to the link in my bio and it will say schedule a conversation. You can go to that link and schedule a conversation. There's a short application there, quick 5-minute application, and we can get on a call and see if we would be a good fit. But I would love to work with you. I'm only working with 40 women this year. That's my number. It's my cap, because we got a baby coming. So I would love for you to be one of those 40 women that I support through the year. How do you prepare to receive blessings? Well, step number one is admitting that you want those things and not giving yourself a plan B. Not giving yourself, well, I want it, but if I don't get it, I'll be fine. No, there is no other option. Trying to get over a heartbreak. You know what would be very valuable for you? I just did a scope 2 or 3 nights ago called 3 Tips for Recovering from a Heartbreak. So you can go to the link in my bio as well and watch that Periscope while it's still up, because I do take my scopes down, y'all. All right. How or where did you find your life coach? How do you go about getting one or a mentor? I found my coach on Periscope. And I just follow the spirit. For every one of my coaches, I felt like that's supposed to be my coach. That's the person who can get me where I'm going. And whatever the investment was, I found a way to make it happen. It has never been a comfortable investment, ever. But I found a way to make it happen. Because guess what? Staying where I was more uncomfortable than investing in my next level. I can make money back. I can't get back the time I'm wasting sitting here being miserable. Let's see, tone and pace. Yes, yes, definitely. As you mentioned earlier about attracting men and money, how do you attract money for your business? I would definitely say go and grab that men and money masterclass, so that you're clear on all the things, A, that are holding you back from attracting that money. And then B, the first step I would say in attracting money for your business is to be about service. Be about service. Know what your why is. Know what you are giving people and how valuable it is. And you believe in that. You believe in that value and be willing to charge for it. And she is truly amazing, ladies. Yeah, I have a couple clients that are on here. Join the Queen Tribe, ladies. Yes, definitely. You're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you guys for the congratulations on our newest baby. This is baby number 4. So very, very excited. Excited. And ready to meet this little one. So are there any more questions? Any more questions? I know that I talk about a pretty sensitive subject. So if you have questions that you would like to talk about with me personally, and you know that you are ready to move forward with investing in yourself, then I would definitely say to tap that link in my bio. Tap that link in my bio so that we can have that conversation, so that you can schedule that conversation. How do you get over the shyness of charging? Hey, Sean, how do you get over the shyness of charging? Get tired of being broke. Get tired of being broke. That's the best way I can put that. Get tired of not making what you want to make. And, realize, because that's kind of like cut and dry, realize that you are robbing someone of something that they need by not serving, by not charging for your services. You are robbing someone of the opportunity to invest in themselves. And that's what made me realize, like, my coach held space for me to invest in myself. And you're robbing someone of the opportunity to invest in themselves, to get to that next level, because you're not serving what you have from your highest place. And the better you charge for your services, the better you're able to serve. Because I can't serve you if I'm worried about how I'm gonna pay my light bill, or I'm worried about how I'm gonna pay my mortgage, or I'm worried about how I'm gonna, you know, handle all the things that I need to handle. I can't be of service to my clients. So that's how, for me, I got over not charging. Let me see. Can you be my coach? I certainly can. You can go to the link in my bio and apply for coaching. How do you get energy? I eat well and I wake up early and I take naps. Eat well, wake up early, take naps. I woke up at 5 this morning and I was like, Lord, I am so late. Like the whole day got away from me because I woke up at 5 o'clock. So wake up early, because I also homeschool my children. So there's that. You gotta start early. Asking the right questions is a gift, absolutely, and you're gifted. Thank you very much. So are there any more questions? Let me see where we are with the time. It is 1:38. We have like 7 minutes. I can't find the scheduling link. It says schedule a conversation at the link in my bio, not Business Rules for Women's bio, but my personal Instagram, which you can find right here at the bottom if you tap the Inspired Life. But you know my page, Hazel Justice. You've been following for years, girl. Naps, that I was missing out. Yes, I take naps. I take naps. I take 20 and 30 minute naps. I thought that makes me guilty. So just like charging, in order for you to serve in your life, you have to be well rested. You have to be well rested. If you are tapping and you're not getting anything, then go to bit.ly/queenup. bit.ly/queenup. Let me make sure that my life is together over here. Yeah, you should be getting the schedule a conversation. Oh, you know what? All right, I just corrected it. That was my mistake. The way that I inserted the link was wrong. Makes sense. What's your page on Instagram? Right down here at the bottom, at The Inspired Life. But yes, you have to be well rested in order to serve. Any tips for creating a successful vision board? Yes, put some action steps on it and put pictures of yourself. You should be on your vision board. Looking at other people living their lives will rarely create results for you. Put you on there, and for each of your areas of vision, have a process. The promise is in the process. And many times we get worn out, burnt out, looking for the promise because we didn't picture ourselves also inside of the process. So that person who says, oh, I want to lose 20 pounds this year, but and has pictures of beautiful, shapely women on their board, but never put a picture of a treadmill or a picture of a personal trainer or a picture of actually working out, will get burnt out as they're accomplishing that vision because they didn't see themselves inside of the process. So remember that the promise is in the process and put yourself on there. I just bought a new mattress because rest is a priority. It absolutely is. Absolutely. So are there any other questions, comments? These questions have been very, very valuable, ladies. So for those of you who want more, who want to take that Men and Money Masterclass, then definitely go to the link in the Business Rules for Women bio. Use code BRFW, all caps, BRFW, it's only four letters, and you can get $300 off of the Men and Money Masterclass. Men and Money Masterclass. Do you have to have a certain number of followers in your story? I believe so. So, any other questions? 4 minutes. If y'all don't have any questions, then I will definitely go nap in those four minutes. My children are woke now, so there's that. And thank you all for giving me a bit of your time. Did you go to the link in my bio? How was it juggling getting married and trying to start your business? I didn't do them both at once. I got married first and I started my business second. I got married first and I started my business second. So bit.ly/queenup should be giving you an application. bit.ly/queenup. I'm looking at it now. Should be giving you an application. And there's me. I would screen share, but I can't do that. Thank you so much for always supporting. Thank you very much for being here. Thank all of you for your time. Do you have a Facebook community? Yes, I do. It's called The Queen Tribe. The Queen Tribe. And you can go ahead and look for that. bit.ly/queenup. Yes, thank you, Jessica, one of my beautiful and fabulous clients. Thank you. Thank you for showing up. I appreciate you. So peace and love, y'all. Thank you again. I will see you all next Wednesday. Mark your calendars.